This is an example of a modern men's accessory that did go out of style. Now, in case you don't know the history of the pocket watch, this was a modern men's accessory that was on the cutting edge of style and basically status for almost 400 years. A man with a pocket watch, he was going places. He was a man that was in charge, that actually could afford to purchase one because they weren't cheap. And this was something that you used not just to tell time, but to also tell those around you that you were the man. Now, in the 1920s, we saw the decline of the pocket watch. The wristwatch, which had gained favor with young soldiers in World War I, was now becoming in fashion and was the go-to piece. Pocket watches were just kind of falling to the wayside. Function-wise, they still did the job, but when it came to ease of checking the time, when it came to the latest fashions, they couldn't compete with those new wristwatches. And that takes us to the first item on this list, the wristwatch. Now, are all modern watches going to be timeless? Of course not. There are pieces that are more technical oriented, ones that are going to change every few years because as technology moves. No, what I'm talking about are more of the automatic movement watches, the quartz movement watches, watches that have kind of already reached their apex point. Now, do you need to get a fancy dive watch that costs thousands of dollars? Of course not. Gentlemen, modern, timeless style comes in a variety of forms at a variety of prices. Seriously, for less than a couple hundred bucks, you'll be amazed at what you can find out there. Next up on my list of accessories that will never go out of style, a classic pair of shades. Now, sunglasses in various forms have been used by human beings for a long, long time. Seriously, we go back to prehistoric times. We have the Inuit people using shaped walrus tusk to actually eliminate a lot of the glare when they're hunting out there in the Arctic. We see emperors in China using them in the 12th century, and then the 1750s over in Europe, you just had people that liked to see things in a tinted glow. Now, sunglasses as an accessory aren't going anywhere. Why? They're functional. They protect your eyes and they help you see better. Now, what are the styles I recommend? The ones that work for most face shapes and are going to be around for years to come? First up, aviators. Aviators, as the name implies, were developed to protect pilots at high altitudes from the harmful rays of the sun. The teardrop design is actually used and very effective to cover a large part of the eye socket, and that's going to be the key feature of this style. You're also going to notice they usually use a very lightweight metal frame. Next up, we've got Wayfarers, defined by their heavier, attention-grabbing frame. Made from acetate, a form of plastic, these frames are going to, you require a bit more confidence to pull these off, but I think they're a classic style that work with a wide variety of face shapes. Can't decide between the two? Consider a pair of Clubmasters. So similar to Wayfarers, they have the strong upper acetate frame, but you'll notice they're frameless underneath the bottom part of the lens. Personally, this is one of my favorite styles because it's so versatile. At the same time, it's not nearly as popular as aviators or wayfarers. Quick question. All these masks you see people wearing, do you think this is going to be a timeless accessory? My thoughts? Of course not. In the next couple of years, these are going to be relics of a time past. That being said, in public spaces until further notice, you still have to wear a face covering. So wouldn't it be cool if there was a face covering that was also a timeless accessory? Well, gents, there is the neck gaiter. Lightweight neck gaiters like this are perfect for sun protection, wind protection. You're going on a run in the desert, get this thing wet, you're going to cool yourself down. But what about for dust protection? What about for germ protection? Well, today's sponsor, Slit Gator, has created an ultra-breathable, moisture-wicking neck gaiter. The beauty of this neck gaiter is it uses reusable, washable air filters in addition to the gaiter itself. The Slit Gator's protective barrier can reduce the spread of viruses, bacteria, and other airborne pathogens. I love what these guys are doing. They're taking a classic, timeless piece of men's gear. This is something you can use again and again. I've got gaiters I've had for 20 years. What I love about this, it's well made, and it's gonna be useful even if you stop wearing masks. Now, the removable, reusable filter system works like this. So when you turn the Slit Gator inside out, what you're gonna see is there's a pocket right here where the filter fits in perfectly. As you can see, you've got a snap here and a snap here. The filter fits right in and stays in place. Now, the gaiter itself is fully functional and you can adjust the tightness both on the bottom and the top opening. I also appreciate the adjustable nose piece. This ensures a closer fit around the nose to prevent fogging of your glasses. And one of my favorite things about this company, they actually listened to you guys, the customers. You guys said, hey, I live in a hot climate. I don't need that cold weather set. So just give me the single hot weather gaiter. Boom, they did it right here. Or if you live up in Canada, you live in the northern United States like I do, you appreciate the cold weather gaiter and the hot weather gaiter set, which I think is still a great deal. Seriously, gents, it's a great company. I'm proud to support them. I use this product. I have my kids use this product. And did I mention it's incredibly affordable? Use that link down in the description of today's video to get the best deal out there on the web. Now, what about jewelry? Is it a timeless men's accessory? Now, I know a lot of you guys in the audience are pretty conservative, and you think the only ring a man should wear is his wedding ring. But gents, I'm a student of history, and for thousands of years, men have used jewelry to send signals of status. Not only that they're married, but that they've got means to take care of others or that they are an important person. In fact, getting back to our first point, you could argue nice, expensive watches, those are simply status pieces. Bracelets, beads, in many cultures throughout history, this has been a form of currency. So if you had this, you obviously had wealth because you were wearing it. The same with precious metals, gold, silver. It wasn't easily found. It was a form of currency. So the fact that you had extra to wear on you, this showed the world and people you didn't know that you were a man of importance. Now, how important is this in today's modern society when you got Bitcoin millionaires out there wearing sweatshirts, jeans, and running shoes? My answer is it still matters a lot because you like to think you're a logical person, yet every single day you make shortcuts, and we are programmed by society, whether it's good or bad, to look for symbols of status, and jewelry is one of them. On a side note, I think it's interesting that some jewelry has become smart. This right here, this ring, it tracks my movement, tracks my temperature, tracks actually how I sleep, and it helps me improve by having that data in front of me every single day. And gents, I know you got an opinion on jewelry. Agree, disagree, how much is too much? Let me know down in the comments. The next accessory that's timeless will never go out of style, the pen. Now, this accessory being on the list probably surprises a lot of you guys, because let's just face it, the vast majority of men do not care about pens. But if you look at the top 10% of men, those that are making the most income, what are they probably doing on a daily, if not weekly basis? Signing important documents. Lawyers, consultants, doctors. That insurance agent earning over $100,000 a year, he understands the importance of pens, and that's why he gives them out with his logo on them. But seriously, if you're a realtor and you want clients to come back, why not give them a really nice pen that's got your logo on it discreetly, but commemorates them buying this home and signing for it? For guys that journal, you like to have a nice pen, and this is a little bit old school, but my wife gave me this pen, and it basically says, "To live means to love you." And I keep this, and pens are still one of those things I think that people can ascribe a lot of meaning to, and I think are going to still be a timeless accessory. Now guys, if you're enjoying today's video, do me a favor, destroy that like button. Seriously, smash it, bash it, treat it like a redheaded stepchild. Gents, when you comment, like, dislike, it helps these videos do better. So imagine this, you're going into an interview for a small startup in New York. You got your sports jacket on, you walk in, you start the conversation, and immediately the guy interviewing says, "I love your pin." What does that pin say? Hustle harder. Now with this one small accessory, you just told this guy that I am here to make things happen. If you're gonna need me to work extra hours, work on the weekends, I'm here, I'm hungry, I'm ready to go. Now, pins are interesting. They've been around for a long time, and I like these because they're like salt with food. You just add a little bit and it adds a lot of flavor. And this can be something you've got a pretty mundane outfit. You got your uniform at work, but you put on a pin, and all of a sudden, it changes the whole dynamic. And we see this all over in politics. For some reason, in the United States, if you're not wearing an American flag on your lapel, you're somehow not a patriot. Pins can incite feelings. They are a very powerful small accessory that you can put on a backpack, you can put on a hat, you can put on a variety of different, you can wear it on a t-shirt, and all of a sudden it can change the dynamic of the conversations you're having. Now for this next accessory, I had to throw on a jacket here, but don't forget about the classic pocket square. Whenever you put on a sports jacket, blazer jacket, suit jacket, this breast pocket needs to be stuffed. Now for the guys just starting off, a simple white pocket square is all you need. Either made from linen or cotton, go ahead and just go with a square presidential fold. This is gonna do the job. Feeling a little bit more adventurous, go with a classic paisley. This pattern coming out of India is amazing because of all the colors and the patterns in this. And the way to make it work with any jacket or shirt, just make sure that one of the colors here matches one of the colors in the jacket or the shirt. Now, when it comes to accessories and patterns in general, I like to have a little bit more fun with the patterns in my accessories. When it comes to my jackets, when it comes to my shirts, I'm usually not going to go for dots, but you can use these in a pocket square or even in a handkerchief. And in case you're wondering, this one here is for blowing, made from cotton. This one here, made from silk, is made for stuffing into the pocket. And I'm curious, gents, what do you think of handkerchiefs? Yes or no? Let me know down in the comments. Me personally, I like them. And why? Because as long as humans have fluids coming out of their body, it's nice to have a handy handkerchief, and they can also double if they've got a nice pattern as a pocket square. The next timeless accessory not going anywhere, hats. And I know a lot of you guys think, oh, come on, Antonio, 1930s, 1940s, that was the time of fedoras. Hats have gone out. No, they haven't. Look in the military. You've got millions of men wearing headwear. And nowadays, if you're bald, if you don't have much hair on your head, you know the value of a hat protecting your head. I've been wearing a flat cap lately, and I've got a full head of hair, and I love it. So tons of options out there. You've got trilbies, you've got the fedora, you've got flat caps, you got newsboy. Find the hat that works for you and own it. So what video to watch next? How about this? 9 practical pieces of clothing that for some reason 99% of men do not own. Well, I don't know if exactly 99% don't own, but the vast majority of men do not own these 9 practical items. What are they? Find out in this video right here.